So we want to attack this subject of fitting in and actually not worrying about it and what it looks like as an artist. Now, we have mentioned in another video in this series that you should actually figure out your target market and know who you want to reach. But that doesn't always mean you're going to feel like you fit into your industry. That's something as an artist I have struggled with. Have you ever struggled with that, Grace?
Yes.
Yeah.
More than a couple times.
A lot of
like
us.
All the time.
Yeah. And I ask Grace and I tell you myself that we have struggled with that so that you know if you struggle with this same thing that you're not alone. And I think it's actually a very unique gift when you don't fit into your industry. That means that you have something very unique to offer. So if somebody doesn't write like you, sound like you, design like you, good. And I know there's a fear there, though, that, you know, you might not actually reach people or nobody might want to hear what you have to say. You know what I mean? But there is a great unique gift that you actually have something that has never been done before. You're actually writing, doing whatever you're doing from a unique perspective that's yet to be heard from before. And that's really special. So I want to give you some advice. When it comes to fitting in, you can just stop worrying about it. Save yourself the mental exertion and effort and just stop worrying about it. Let it just fall to the wayside. And I want to, along with Grace, we want to encourage you and release you to just go ahead and do your creative thing. Do your creative thing, do your artwork, do your creative passion, and let the cards, you know, as an analogy, fall where they fall. If you don't ever feel like you fit in, that's okay. It's just honestly a feeling. But, you know, you might not fit in, honestly, but that's okay. There will be, most likely, if your work is quality, there's going to be people who resonate with what you're doing, who want to follow you, who want to hear you, see you, and be a part of your art form. So that's what I have to say. What do you have to say about this, Grace?
Well, yeah, just really pursuing your art and your vision that you have inside you should really be first and foremost, rather than worrying about where you fit and then mimicking your art based on the genre or niche or whatever, where you feel like you fit or where you want to fit even. Just do what's in your heart. I mean, seriously, pursue that first and foremost. Again, yeah, and we talk about it in other videos. Keep up with your industry. You should be aware of trends. You should be aware of who you're trying to reach and where they are online and in the world and in society and things like that.
Right, so you do need to do some research.
Yeah, you need some research and some, you know, you don't want to be so unique and out there that absolutely nobody can relate to you. But that shouldn't be the main thing you focus on all the time, because if you focus on that too much, especially when you're first getting going, it can really just stop you. Paralyze you, stop you, because first and foremost, you want to create your art. You want to get your art out there. You need to create your art. If you have the perfect niche, but you have no art to put into it, that doesn't do any good either.
Let's create
the art first.
Right.
That needs to be your primary goal, I guess, your duty to yourself.
Right.
And if you don't feel like you fit, whether it's at first or ever, you know, that's okay. You do need to be true to yourself first. And then more than likely, you will find some area where you at least sort of fit, or find other people who then fit in with you or something like that if you pursue it long enough. But don't let the definition of where do I fit be the first and foremost thing you focus on. And by all means, don't let it paralyze you or block you or stop you from creating or make you feel like you need to alter your creations so much that it's no longer recognizable as your own,
or
that you are proud of it. You want to be proud of what you produce, and you want to feel like it's coming from a genuine place inside you. That should be the main thing that you focus on.
Yeah, because what you have to give is super valuable to the world around us. And
absolutely,
even though you might not always believe that or ever believe that, you have a unique voice. You have a unique way of thinking that no one else has. So right away, whatever you put your hands to or your voice to or whatever you produce is going to be very unique, unless you try to fit into an industry by copying somebody else. But we don't really need any more copies. We need you to be you. And so we want to take the paralysis out of your analysis. I've heard people say that before. There's so much paralysis in your over-analysis of where you fit. Take that, throw it away. The honest reality is that you do fit because you're just making the art. Like if you are a musician, you are in the music industry. Yeah. You don't have to have a well-pronounced place. The fact is, and a good analogy is when you're someone's child, right? There might be 12 kids in this family, but at the end of the day, there's a place for you at the table, and none of your brothers and sisters might even be like you, but you're still a part of the family.
Yeah.
So whether you're 1 year old or 55 years old, you're still a part of the family. So it doesn't matter when you start or how young you are in the industry, you have a place. And the reality is we want you to stop thinking about it, because I feel like if I would have stopped thinking about it when I was 10 years, 10 years ago when I was doing this, if I would have not been thinking about it, I would have propelled a lot quicker. And we know there's a lot of you guys out there that are thinking about it. So we want to free you now and say it's a common feeling and you do have a place. So move forward, create your art, reach the people you're designed to reach. So how can you, this is my takeaway question, how can you better move past this? How can you move past this? Like, what are some actionable steps that you can do to move past the fact that you don't feel like you can fit into this industry that you're actually in, whether you think you are or not? What are some steps that you can do? Whether it's saying every day, like, I am in the music industry, or just making your music and just cutting it out of your life.
Go ahead and write a song and sing it. And by definition, that makes you a musician, that makes you a singer. You know, go ahead and write that blog post, that makes you a writer. Whatever, go ahead and, you know, paint makeup on somebody for a school play, and that makes you a makeup artist.
Right.
You know, and it doesn't matter where you're fitting in right now. Just what do you feel, what are the actionable steps you can do to pursue what you feel like you should be doing? Not necessarily what the industry might be calling itself right now, or what subgenre you fit in or don't fit into right now.
Yeah, forget where you fit. And actually just go do it. And it'll naturally open for you. You'll find that you have a place at the table that you're a part.
Absolutely.